हेलो, दिस इज आश्लेषा अधट राव, लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट। इन प्रीवियस पीपीटी वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर एब्स्ट्रैक्ट विंडोइंग टूलकिट एंड वी कवर द पार्ट इंट्रोडक्शन हायरार्की ऑफ AWT एंड सैंपल विंडोड प्रोग्राम। इन दिस पीपीटी आई एम गोइंग टू टेक AWT controls. So, as we see in hierarchy of AWT, there are visual components which is called as AWT controls. So, let's start with AWT controls. Every user interface consider the following three main aspects: user interface elements, layouts, and behavior. First is user and interface elements, that is UI elements. These are the core visual elements the user eventually sees and interacts with. AWT provides a huge list of widely used and common elements varying from basic to complex, which we will cover in this tutorial. The visual element means our components, buttons, text box, label, choice controls, scroll bar, and so on. The second element is layouts. They define how user interface elements should be organized on the screen and provide a final look and feel to the GUI. This part will be covered in layout chapter. First, we discussing the controls in detail, and again the next point, layout. So the third aspect is behavior. These are events which occur when the user interacts with UI elements. This part will be covered in event handling chapter. So basically there are three main aspects. First is user interface elements, second is layouts, and third one is behavior. In that, user elements means our AWT controls, and then layout means there are different types of layout which allow us to lay down our user elements in organized form on the screen. And third one is behavior, means suppose I am clicking submit button, then some action is performed, some event is occurred on that when I am going to click the button, that is called as event handling. This is the behavior of that submit button. So this is the hierarchy of our AWT in short. Just remind, the first base class is object, then component, which is the top level of the AWT hierarchy. Then the subclass container has two subclasses, window and panel. And component has the visual components, which means UI elements, that is button, text, list, and so on. This is the hierarchy of our AWT. So every AWT controls inherits properties from component class. So the component, what is the component? A component is an abstract superclass for GUI controls, and it represents an object with graphical representation. So the AWT UI elements, first one is label. In short, a label is object of a component for placing text in a container. Second control is button. This class creates a labeled button. Third, checkbox. A checkbox is a graphical component that can be in either an on or off state, means which is true or false. The next control is checkbox group. The checkbox group is a class that is used to group as a set of checkbox. So for example, what do we mean by checkbox group is if there is an option for example hobbies, there is a tag named hobbies, and I can have number of hobbies, for example reading books, watching TV, etc. So these are the hobbies are grouped under the class hobbies, which can say it as a group of hobbies, which is checkbox group. We will look into in further in detail. So just remind one thing that the checkbox group is a class which is used as a group of set of checkboxes. So the next UI control is the list component. The list component presents the user with a scrolling list of text items. User. The next control is image. An image control is superclass for all image classes representing graphical images. The next control is scroll bar. A scroll bar control represents a scroll bar component in order to enable user to select from range of values. The next control is dialog. A dialog control represents a top level window with a title and border used to take some form of input from the user. The next control is file dialog. A file dialog control represents a dialog window from which the user can select a file. So these are the UI elements. We have some we can say that a definition for that particular element. So, adding and removing controls. How to use controls? To include a control in a window, you must add it to the window. To do so, you must first create an instance of the desired control and then add it to a window by calling add function, which is defined by container. The add method has several forms. The following form is the one that is used for the first part of this chapter. We can define add method as component add in bracket the object of that component. Here It's an instance of the control that you want to add. A reference is returned. Once a control has been added, it will automatically be visible whenever its parent's window is displayed. Sometimes you will want to remove a control from a window then when the control is no longer needed. To do so, we call remove. This is a method by container. The general form void remove and component object. Here, the object is a reference to the control you want to remove. So basically, these are the methods defined by the container. For adding the control, we must use add method, and for removing the component, we use remove method. So our first control is label. As we discussed, a label is a GUI control which can be used to display static text. Label can be created using label class and its constructors, which are listed below. There are three constructors. First, empty constructor. Second, the parameterized constructor, where we are passing the string as a label. And third constructor is string with integer how. That how specifies the text alignment. The values are label.left, label.center, or label.right. Integer how specifies the text alignment in the form of left, right, and center, and the values are defined as label.left, label.center, or label.right. Some of the methods available in the label class are as follows. The first method is void set text parameter string. This function is to set or assign text to the label. The second method is string get text. This method is used to retrieve the text of that label. Third method is void set alignment in bracket integer how. To set the alignment of the text in a label, this method is used. So for setting the alignment, we need to pass the values label.left, label.center, or label.right. The fourth method is integer get alignment. This method is used to get the alignment of the text in a label. Constructor close. The next main method I am calling my constructor. To compile this program, Java C class name dot java, and to run simply Java class name. Here you can see to compile Java C myframe dot java and to run Java myframe. After successfully executed, the window is displayed as shown and the label is created. Next control is buttons. The most widely used control is the push button. A push button is a component that contains a label and that generates an event when it is pressed. Push buttons are objects of type button. Button defines these two constructors. First one empty constructor and second one is parameterized constructor by passing string to that button. The first version creates an empty button and the second creates a button that contains string as a label to that button. After a button has been created, we can set its label by calling setLabel and we can retrieve its label by calling getLabel. The setLabel and getLabel are the other methods of button. We can use that. The next control is checkboxes. A checkbox is a control that is used to turn an option on or off. It consists of a small box that can either contain a check mark or not. There is a label associated with each checkbox that describes what option the box represents. We change the state of a checkbox by clicking on it. Checkboxes can be used individually or as part of a group. Checkboxes are object of the checkbox class. Checkbox supports these constructors. First, empty constructor. The first form creates a checkbox whose label is initially blank. The state of the checkbox is unchecked. Second constructor is parameterized constructor by passing the string. The second form creates a checkbox whose label is specified by string. The state of the checkbox is unchecked. Third constructor by passing two arguments. First argument string and second is boolean on and off. The third form allows us to set the initial state of checkbox. If on is true, the checkbox is initially checked, otherwise it is cleared or unchecked. Fourth, checkbox string, boolean on, checkbox group and object of that checkbox group. The fourth and the fifth form creates a checkbox whose label is specified by string and whose group is specified by checkbox group, that is the object of your checkbox group class. And the fifth constructor is with three parameters: string, checkbox group CB group and boolean on. If this checkbox is not part of a group, then the object of checkbox group must be null. The value of and of on determines the initial state of the checkbox. So these are the five constructors with their explanation. You have to remind all these constructors and use suitable one in your program. In order to retrieve the current state of checkbox, call getState method. For setting its state, call setState method. We can obtain the current label associated with a checkbox by calling getLabel. For setting the label, set label. These are the methods for checkbox. These methods are defined as follows: Boolean get state, void set state by passing the parameter Boolean on or off. Third, string get label, and fourth one is set label by passing the string. Here, if on is true, the box is checked. If it is false, the box is cleared, that is unchecked. The string passed in str becomes the new label associated with the invoking checkbox. So these are the methods of checkboxes, and this is the example of checkbox. Here I am going to create the object of checkboxes by assigning the name of operating system. Okay, and here I am using one of the constructor of checkboxes. So for Windows 98, I am passing the string, the null and true. This is one of the checkboxes defined earlier. So we can define the checkboxes as shown. After checkboxes are defined, we must add them by using add method. So to run the program by using applet viewer, the window will appear as shown. Next control is checkbox group. It is possible to create a set of mutually exclusive checkboxes in which one and only one checkbox in the group can be checked at any one time. These checkboxes are often called radio buttons because they act like the station selector on a car radio. Only one station can be selected at a time. For creating a set of mutually exclusive checkboxes, we must first define the group to which they will belong and then specify that group when we construct the checkboxes. Checkbox group are object of type checkbox group. Only the default constructor is defined, which creates an empty group. We can determine which checkbox in a group is currently selected by calling getSelectedCheckbox method. We can set a checkbox by calling setSelectedCheckbox method. So these methods are as follows: void getSelectedCheckbox and void setSelectedCheckbox checkbox wh. Here wh is the checkbox that we want to be selected. The previously selected checkbox will be turned off. We need to add those checkboxes. Here I am using using the method getSelectedCheckboxes because we can declare that which checkbox is currently active or not. So here in paint method I am going to print the message on that applet by using getSelectedCheckbox method. Okay, so here one more thing, we need to add that checkboxes on that group. So here checkbox, the group name of checkbox, and the selected state of that checkbox. Means if you want that Windows 98 to be selected by default, then you should state the checkbox to true, or set the visibility for that checkbox is true. So these checkbox are part of your defined checkbox group. So this is the method where we can create a group of checkboxes. After successfully executed your program, the window will appear as shown. And as we know, we state the visibility for our Windows 98 to true. We can see that by default the Windows 98 option became selected or marked as check. The next is choice controls. The choice class is used to create a pop-up list of items from which the user may choose. Thus, a choice control is a form of menus. When inactive, a choice component takes up only enough space to show the currently selected item. When the user clicks on it, the whole list of choices pops up and a new selection can be made. Each item in the list is a string that appears as a left justified label in the order it is added to the choice object. Choice only defines the default constructor, which creates an empty list. In order to add a selection to the list, add method is used and it has this general form, void add string name. Here, name is the name of the item being added. Items are added to the list in order in which calls to add occur. In order to determine which item is currently selected, we may call either any of the following methods: string get selected item or integer get selected index. The get selected item method returns a string containing the name of the item, and the get selected index returns the index of the item. The first item is at index 0. By default, the first item added to the list is selected. For obtaining the number of items in the list, call getItemCount method. We can set the currently selected item using the select method with either a zero based index or a string that will match a name in the list. The methods are shown below. First, the get integer get item count. Second, void select integer index. Third, void select string name. Given an index, we can obtain the name associated with the item at that index by calling get item, which has the following general form: string get item integer index. Here, index specifies the index of the desired item. So this is the example of choice. Here I am going to create the object OS and browser as a choice. On that OS, I am going to add the list of different operating system as follows: os.add windows 98, os.add windows NT 2000, os.add solaris, and so on. And for browser, I am going to add the name of browsers as show browser that dot add Netscape 3.x. The versions of Netscapes are added to the list of or to the choices of browser. Next, browser dot select method is used because so that the by default item is selected as Netscape 4.x, and after adding the items on your choices, we need to add that choice on your applet by using add method just shown here. Add OS, add browser, and complete your code. After successfully executed the program, the output will be shown as this. By default, the browser is selected Netscape 4.x and the list is generated as shown here. Thank you.